Hello and welcome to the first part of the LEGO Spike Prime Scratch tutorial series. In this series, I will try to explain the LEGO Scratch programming environment for the LEGO Spike Prime robot, and I will make playlists with the same overall topics for Robot Inventor, for Spike Prime, and for the LEGO Mindstorms EV3. So I will link the playlists in the video description. You can check the playlist for your model, and most parts will be the same for all of the systems because the programming environment is very similar, but some parts, like this first part, will be for Spike Prime only. Make sure to check the right part or to check the right playlist for your robot model. In this case, it's for Spike Prime, or to be a bit more precise, for the Spike Prime software, because you can also use this for Robot Inventor, but you won't have the features of the Robot Inventor. So you won't have the remote control feature. You will have some additional features, which we will cover later. There are two major ways to get this software. You can either download it from the LEGO Education website. I will link that in the video description. Here you can select your operating system and then download the app or download the installer. Or depending on your operating system, you might have a store, like the Microsoft Store in my case for Windows, and there you can download this app as well. So let's get back to the app. This is the first part, so I will cover the basics of the organization of the app, how you can use it, and we will get into the details of programming in the next parts. So this is the first page. We can create a new project. We can go to a starting area that explains some things. We can access the units. So here you can find models or projects that you can do. And I suggest you to download this project for this tutorial, because then you will get the build tab, and in the build tab you will get the driving base. This will be the main robot for this tutorial. That's this one. I suggest you to build it with all the extras for this tutorial. So you can build the driving base. You can build the driving base too with this accessory and the sensors. I think that here you get this. You don't have to build this arm, but the other accessories. And then you can build the color sensor. And that will be the model that I will try to use. You can also try to build your own model that has similar motors or similar functionalities, but I will cover this model. This model has two motors, one per side for the drive. So moving one motor will turn the model left, moving the other one will turn the model right. Both will drive forwards. And we have the force sensor, but we won't use that much in this tutorial. We have the ultrasonic sensor, and we have the color sensor that looks at the bottom. The ultrasonic sensor should look to the front, and we have this attachment. So we have a third motor that does something that makes sense. Here's the list of the projects. That's not so important, but important is this option. You can change the settings. And even more helpful is that here you can find a help file, which information which stores information for the environment and for the usage of the stuff. So this is helpful, but it's also a large compilation of text, so it's not really convenient. But now let's open a new project. We can go back to the Home tab, and here we can create a new project and select word blocks. These word blocks are very similar to Scratch, so you might know similar languages, but I will try to cover everything from the basics to the more advanced stuff. And this is how the project is organized. We have a start point where we can attach some blocks. The blocks are in different categories, so we can control the motors, the movement. Movement controls two motors at the same time. We have light, we have sound, we have events. So we can add other start blocks. We have control that controls the flow of the program, but more on that later. We can access the sensors, make a few operations, and have more advanced stuff. You can press here to connect the hub. So let me turn the hub on. You connect it via USB or via Bluetooth. In my case, I will connect it via Bluetooth, and they are already paired, so I can press on connect. You might have to press the Bluetooth button on top if you connect it via Bluetooth for the first time. But now I have the sensor readings and I can access all the stuff, but we will cover all of that in the later part. So thanks for watching this video so far. I hope that you liked it. Feel free to give me ideas for projects that you want to see in the comments, because this tutorial should live for both, or it should live with your ideas. That would be very helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next part, and bye.